when I was shopping back then, I realized that the HOA fee for townhouses and condos is very high. It's like anywhere between 200, 400, or even higher than that. And if you calculate the cost, your monthly, it comes out to a lot more. It comes out to almost $2,000 just for a condo or townhouse. So I'm like, is that really worth it? You're paying a lot more per month for less. So it didn't make any sense to me to buy. So I stopped looking after that. And then 2 years later, because I found out that the interest rates were low, I was like, okay, let me start looking for houses again. So I started back in, I think, July of this year. So I was putting offers down on houses and stuff, but I didn't have any luck because other people were putting higher offers than mine. So I started getting more aggressive. I started shopping on weekdays during evening hours. And you were working with me between like anywhere from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. doesn't matter. As soon as a house became available, we would go out, we would shop. And if I liked it, I would put an offer down. So then we came to this house. The first day it came on the market, we went there. We saw the house at around, I think, 7 o'clock or something. We talked outside for a bit. I told him I liked the house. So we went back to the owner. We knocked on his door again. And we told him, hey, I really like your house and I'll pay you this much for it. So it was a little bit over the asking price, but he took my offer, even though other people put higher offers than mine. Because I reminded him of his daughter and his daughter has a dog. I have a dog. So it was like a really good scenario in my position. So that's how I ended up getting this house, essentially.
Very good. So, you know, to your point, actually, I was definitely there when you gone and met the owner. So I think what you created was a personal touch, and this personal touch somehow, you know, a lot of clients, they don't get it. Like, you know, everyone is not looking for money. Sometimes people, especially when they are selling a house, when they are have an emotional connection, they want someone who will appreciate what they have and how they're going to live into it, you know.
Going to take care of their house. Like money, I know for some people money is everything, but it's not for everyone. Some people look at who will be owning the house too, you know. They want someone who's going to take care of the house as well. So that's another thing to look at too. Not everyone picks money over, you know, other things.
Correct. And I totally remember, you know, when you were looking, you know, the owner basically liked the way you started building a rapport and personal touch. And the good part was that actually we saw the house when they were there in the house. And the next day the realtor was very upset. He was like, you know, I'm getting many high offers than the price you guys are offering. But for some reason, my seller just want to just stuck with your buyer. Like he was like totally upset. And all the way till the last point of the day, he was like, you know, feeling as if like, you know, that something is not right. Like how come we are getting it? And ultimately we end up buying it, you know, that also.
Yeah. And then even my parents were worried when we were under contract. They said that what if the seller backs out? And I'm like, you know, I trust this guy that he's not going to back out because he was only willing to give the house to me. He wasn't willing to give it to anyone else. So that was another thing. The trust was there as well. That's why every step of the way, like no matter with the appraisal or the home inspection, like he stayed there and didn't back out. And I didn't back out either because I have the house now. So,
yeah. And plus, you know, as a customer, it was very important that you were also acting very mature, you know, because you were ignoring the small tidbits here and there. Remember the inspector who you hired, technically, he almost killed the deal because owner's son was there. And when he was saying something, his son heard all those things and he kind of got upset. He was like thinking as if like we're going to go so strong, but you were ready to compromise. You know, that's another positive part. You know, sometimes in my trade, I see
you have to work with the seller to come to an agreement. I mean, you can't ask them to fix everything because that seems a little unreasonable. You have to shoulder something. So I do have some renovations that I'm going through right now, but it's not the end of the world. It'll be a lot better. And plus, I get to make the house the way I like it.
Perfect.
So that's another plus thing too.
So technically, Pooja, so what made you to work with me? You know, what you have to talk on that part? Like how... Because technically, I think we've not seen many houses, right? How many houses I've shown you? Maybe like 10?
Maybe about 10, yeah.
Yeah,
but 10. I worked with other realtors. So before Anil, I worked with, I want to say at least three other real estate agents. And the problem with the first one that I was working with, he didn't have any availability. So every time I asked him to show me any houses on weekends, he said he wasn't available. So then I worked with two other ladies, and they showed me pretty good houses. But then when it came to putting an offer down, my offer just never got accepted. I just wasn't lucky with my offers. So then I decided, you know, maybe I'm just doing something wrong. Maybe I'm not putting the right offer down. And then I started working with Anil because Anil told me that he was closing 4 houses a month. And I was like, that's great. I can close my house in that much time too. So, you know, I worked with him for not too long, actually. I worked with him maybe end of October or beginning of October, and then the closing of the house ended up happening right before Thanksgiving.
Wow, that's
so it wasn't like we worked for a long time either. Yeah. We worked for a very short time and we got the job done. You know, you got your job done and I got my house.
Yes, actually, yeah, you are the first one, actually, you know, because the lender I also used this time, that lender also I not used him before, but what happened, I just happened to use him because he was helping me out to do loan for some of my difficult clients, you know. So sometimes lenders, they want easy file. So this lender was technically was very agile and he was trying his best. So that also helped, you know, the appraisal came good. It was not too high, not too much, and everything well, very well, you know. So I'm very happy, you know. Well, thank you so much, Pooja, for giving time. And, you know, if any time, you know, and I definitely when your house is ready, do invite me. So I just wanted to see before and after how it looks.
Oh, yes, definitely. I'll let you know once it's done. I think like right around Christmas time or a little bit before New Year's, I can probably show you, or even after New Year's is fine.
Yes, and especially this year, since you done and bought house this year, so you will be able to save taxes. And I think the renovation cost and other stuff also will help you to appreciate the price, you know, the price appreciation. So you're basically getting a good rate.
So I actually spoke to, so my contractor, the one that I'm working with, his son is actually a real estate agent. And I think he wants to see the house when it, like right now, it's still being renovated. But he said that once the renovation is done, I could resell it for $380 or more if I wanted to.
Wow. So now look at this. So everyone who might be listening to this video, maybe after we're done. So look at this, like, you know, the Pooja gonna make saving a rate. She got a very good rate of interest because 1% you save, you get technically save $12,000. So knowing Pooja, how much rate you got, Pooja? 2.6. So for 2.65, for a rate like this, like, so technically she's saving almost like 2% from the last year. So every 1% is $12,000. So in a property of worth $300,000, technically you saved almost like $72,000 just on a rate alone. On top of it, you got a property which is 4-bedroom, 2-bath just by using a personal touch. Even though the offers were coming so way high, but just bridging a connection and then sticking to the property, you know, ignoring the small things, ignoring the small leakage here and there, ignoring the all that stuff. And now you will be able to reap the rewards by appreciating by doing the right construction. Not too much, not too less, you know, just right.
Yeah, it's whatever needs to be done. Like, I know the bathrooms don't need to be done, so I'm not doing the bathrooms. I'm not doing any floor or anything like that. I'm only touching up the kitchen, the deck, things like that. It's whatever's necessary.
Very good, very good. Thank you, Pooja. Thanks for giving time. You know, I do appreciate, and thanks for giving feedback on Google. Try Zillow if that helps. Otherwise, you know, I'm going to keep bothering you.
Yeah, I'll try to do it on Zillow as well. Okay. If it's working, then I'll put it on there too. Awesome. I'll copy it on there too.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Nice talking to you.
Right, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.